Hello everybody, now we are going to see one problem. Okay, yesterday this problem was given in the yesterday's worksheet, okay, worksheet number 7. So there is, we need to do some changes in that. Okay, so we will see this example how to solve. Okay, what is the given example? See, a random survey of the numbers of children of various age groups playing in a park are as found below. Draw a histogram for the data. Okay, histogram for the data. Okay, one thing we know that in histogram the intervals which are given, it should be continuous. Understood? That means exclusion. Understood? So here if you see the intervals 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, 5 to 7, 7 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 17. These intervals are continuous, but class size is not equal. Class size is different. See here, what is the class size of this? 2 minus 1, 1. Class size is 1. 3 minus 2, 1. 5 minus 3, 2. 7 minus 5, 2. 10 minus 7, 3. 15 minus 10, 5. 15 minus, 17 minus 15 is 2. Okay. So class size is different. Okay. When class size is different, that time we need to do some modification in the given data. Okay, in the given data. So how to do that? That we are going to see. So see, first two columns are going to keep as it is. First two columns are will be as it is. Age in years and number of children. Number of children is what is it? It is frequency. Okay, we are going to use this is frequency. Okay. Now one more thing we need to find out class size. Class size. Okay. Class size is 1, here class size we have written, so that we can write here, third column is class size. Okay, in other words also we can say class size means width of rectangle also we can say. For class size we can say width of the rectangle. Width of a rectangle. Understood? Or class size also we can say. What is the class size of this? 2 minus 1 is 1, 3 minus 2 1, here we have written already 2, 2. Then 10 minus 7 3, 10 minus 15, 15 minus 10 is 5, and again 2. Okay, so class size we have left. Now one more thing we need to do, adjusted frequency. Adjusted frequency. Okay, adjusted frequency. We need to do the adjustment in the frequency, that is known as adjusted frequency. Okay, so there is a formula to find out adjusted frequency. Adjustment frequency. What is that formula? Frequency divided by minimum class size divided by class size multiplied by minimum class size. Okay, frequency divided by class size into minimum class frequency. Minimum class size. Now you will ask, what is minimum class size? Minimum class size is here. What is the minimum class size here? 1. Because here class size is 2, 2, 3, 5, 2. Okay, so minimum class size is 1. So that we need to use here. Understood? To adjust the frequency. Okay. So now see here, frequency of the particular class. Frequency of the particular class. What is that? So we will find out this. 5 divided by 1. Class size of this interval is 1. So 5 frequency divided by 1 multiplied by minimum class size is 1. Okay. So what will come? 5. So here the answer is 5. Adjust frequency of the first interval is 5. Okay. Now the same thing. This minimum class size will be constant for all. Okay, all the seven things are given, seven intervals are given. So for that, minimum class size will be constant. So for next one we will take this is, what is frequency? This frequency is 3 divided by 1 multiplied by 1. So that is 3. So here it will become 3. Then 6 divided by 2 multiplied by 1. So it will be 2, 3 is a 6, 3, 1 is a 3. Okay, so here again it is going to become 3. Then 12 divided by 2 will be 6. 6 multiplied by 1 is 6. Okay, 12 divided by 2, 6, 6 into minimum class size is 1, so 6 into 1 is 6. 9 divided by 3, 9 divided by 3 will be 3, 3 ones are 3. Okay, 10 divided by 5, 5 2s are 10, 2 multiplied by 1 is 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2, 2 into 1, 1 is 2. Okay, so this we have done adjusted frequency. Okay, now you will ask, so why we are adjusting frequency? That is important because here see, intervals are not, the class size is not equal. Class size is not equal. Understood? So, this is 1 is 1 to 2, means class size is 1. Here class size is 5, class size is 3, class size is 2. Understood? So, we are doing this adjustment in the rectangles or bar. Okay, there only we will show. Okay, so this information we are going to use to show on the graph. Okay, once again see what we have done. The question was given, these two columns we have taken as it is, then class size of each interval. When we have to do this? When class size are different. Okay, class sizes are different, that time we need to do this adjustment or modification in the given data. So class sizes of this data is 1, here 1, 2, the class size is here limit minus lower limit. Okay, so that is one as class size. So that means we have done class size. Then adjacent frequency. There is a formula to find out adjacent frequency. Frequency divided by class size multiplied by minimum class size. Okay. So what is frequency? Frequency here 5 divided by 1. 5 divided by 1 is 5 multiplied by minimum class size. Minimum class size is 1. Okay. So we have multiplied by 1. So 3 upon 1 into 1 is 3. Like that we have done this. Now this information we have to show on the graph paper. Okay, so first we will use here. See here. Now after this, this is the origin. Okay. Now we need to think about this 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, 5 to 7, 7 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 17. We will keep as it is. Understood? This is 0, 0 to 1 nothing is there, 0 to 1 nothing is there. Understood? 1 to 2. So 1 I have taken here, 1 to 2. Then 2 to 3. So next will come 3. Then after this 3 to 5. 3 to 5. Okay, then 5 to 7, 5 to 7, 7 to 10, 7 to 10, 10 to 15, 10 to 15, and 15 to 7, 15 to 7. Understood? So this we have done on the x-axis. We have taken this information as it were on x-axis. Now adjacent frequency. Adjacent frequency we need to use. Understood? So what is the minimum? Here minimum is 2 and maximum is 6. Understood? So what we can do? Maximum is 6. So minimum we can use like this. Suppose 1, 2, 3. I am going to use here 1. Okay. Then 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Maximum is 6. Understood? So now see first one. 1 to 2. What is the adjacent frequency? 5. So it will go 1 to 2, 5. So 5 is here. Okay, so first is ready. Then 2 to 3. 3 adjacent frequency is 3. So it will come like this. You know that histogram is the grouped frequency distribution. Understood? Then again 3, 3 to 5 is again 3, then 5 to 7 is 6, 5 to 7 is, this is the maximum, so it will come, 5 to 7 is 6, then 7 to 10 is 3 again, 7 to 10 is 3, then 2, and again 2. Okay, so here our histogram is red. Understood? So this way we need to do some adjustment. Here we need to write age in years. Age in years here we have taken. Okay, and this side fifth ways, number of children. Number of children you put here. Understood? So according to this we have done, because here see one thing is important, height of the rectangle. We have modified. Height of the rectangle we have modified. Understood? It was suppose here 6 is given, it was 2. But class size was different. Class size was different. Okay. So see here carefully. 5 to 7. If we are thinking about 5 to 7, we have taken 6. But actually it was given class, it was given 12 and it was 2. Understood? But the class size is different. Here 2. And here class size is 5. So we have taken in the proportion of these rectangles and area. Okay, so see carefully and solve such type of examples in this way. Only here you think we have learned adjacent frequency, that is we have to do with the help of one formula. Okay, okay, see here our next point is cumulative frequency curve or an origin. Okay, cumulative frequency curve or an origin. Understood? Curve or on an origin. Okay. So see here, origin or curve, how to draw that we are going to see. Okay. First step, there are two types, less than method. First we are going to see less than method. Already we have seen how to prepare table for the same, that we have seen. Okay. So with the help of less than method, how to draw cumulative frequency curve or an origin, that we are going to see today. Okay, so see here first thing, here one question is given, draw a cumulative frequency curve or an origin for the following data. Understood? Here it is given class interval frequency 0 to 8, 8 to 16, 16 to 24, 24 to 32, 32 to 40, 40 to 14. Okay, if you will observe, class intervals are same. Class intervals 8 minus 0, 8, 16 minus 8, class size is equal. Okay. Again, one more important thing is class intervals are continuous. Class intervals are continuous. Here 0 to 8, 8 to 16, 16 to 24, 24 to 32, 32, like that. Class intervals are given continuous. Understood? So it is exclusive. Okay. So not necessary to do any changes in the class intervals. That is first thing. If class intervals are discontinuous, then we need to make it continuous. Understood? So see here, first thing is given class interval, that as it is, however it is given, that we will take 8 to 16, 16 to 24, 24 to 32, 32 to 40, and 40 to 40. Okay, this is given. Okay. Now frequency also we will use as it is. Frequency also we will take as it is. Understood? So frequency is given 8, 12, 20, 16, 8 and 10. Okay. Now in third column, we need to find out the cumulative frequency by less than method. Okay. Cumulative frequency less than. Okay, in less than method, what is going to come? 8 will come as it is. Okay, 0 to 8, that is going to come as it is. Now less than 16, how much it will come? 8 to 16 are 12, but less than 16, this the sum of these two, both will come. 12 plus 8 is 20. Okay, less than 16 means all these two columns are going to come. Less than 16 means this is also less than 16, this is also less than 16. Okay, so 12 plus 8 is 20. Now next is less than 24. Less than 24 means this 20 plus 12 plus 8. 20 plus 20 is 40. Okay. Now less than 32. Less than 32 will be this sum is 40 plus this 16. 40 plus 16 is 56. Okay. Now less than 40. Less than 40 is this whole sum plus 8. 56 plus 8 is 64. Okay, and less than 48 is whole, all the sums, sum of all the frequencies will come, that is 64 plus this last one is 10, 64 plus 10 is 70. Okay. So here we have done cumulative frequency by less than method. Understood? So here what is given, what was given, class intervals are given which are continuous. So no need to do any changes in that. Okay. As it is, we have taken frequency, we have taken. First we have seen less than method. We are seeing here less than method. So cumulative frequency by less than method. So first as it is 8, less than 16. Less than 16 is 8 plus 12, 20. Less than 24. Less than 24 means sum of these 3. Less than 32, sum of these 4. Less than 40, sum of these 5 frequencies. Then less than 48, whole addition 70. Understood? Now we need to plot this information on the graph paper. Okay. So now here which we will take, here see, higher limit. Every time we are going to use higher limit as an x coordinate. Understood? So our first point will be 8. Okay. And this frequency 8 8. Then next time 16 16 20. Okay. 24 40. 24 40. Then 32 56. 32 56. After that 40 64. 40 64. 48 74. 48 70. Understood? So we have taken, this is the higher limit and cumulative frequency which we have done by less than limit. So x and y coordinate we are going to plot on the graph. Okay. So now see here x axis, you will see then this is 8 16 24 32 48 48 48. Understood? So we can take directly from 0 to 8. 0 here 8, then 16, then 24, then 32, then 40, and then 48. Okay. If you want, you can take 40, then 56. Okay. So that also you can increase. Now see, on y axis, minimum is 8 and maximum is 74. Minimum is 8 and maximum is 74. So this we will take here. 10, 10 also we can take. So here I am taking 10, then 20, then 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and 80. Okay, maximum is 74. So 80 is enough. Okay, now just we have to plot the points. First 8, 8 means 10 is here, it will come approximately some here. On the graph paper, you will get exactly location of that point. So 8, 8 is here. Okay. Then 16, 20. 16 is here and 20 is here. So they will intersect here. 16, 20. Okay. Then after that 24, 40. 24 and 40. 24 and 40 is here. 24, 40. Okay. 24 is here. 24 we have taken here. Okay. 24 is here. 24, 40. Then 32, 56. 32 and 56. 56, 55. One more. Here it will come. 32. 32, 56. Okay. Then 40, 64. 40 and 64. 64 is here. 40, 64. Okay. And last point is 48, 74. 48, 74 is, 48 is here. 74 will come. 48, 74. And after this, these all the points we need to join with the three hand slips. Okay. So here, okay. So this we have done. Now, this we need to join with the frequency, backside frequency, previous frequency. Frequency will be 0. Here frequency 0 means it will, we can correct this into the origin. Understood? So this is the frequency curve or an origin by less than method we have seen. Understood? Only the thing is that whatever things are given, the classes should be continuous. If it is not continuous, we have to make it. Understood? Then frequency, then cumulative frequency less than method, this we have seen already. Okay? And the low higher limit and the cumulative frequency which we have done, that we have to plot on the graph paper. According to the this, we need to spread the scales x and y axis. Understood?
So this is class intervals. These are the class intervals. Okay, and here what we have taken, if this is frequency. Okay, so this is wireless connected curl or an edge. Okay, see here students, once again we are going to see a cumulative frequency curve or an OGU for the following data, okay, by less than method. Understood? Before this we have seen where classes were continuous, but now the classes which are given, which are discontinuous. Understood? So we need to do some changes in that, okay. See here, class intervals are given 0 to 90, 20 to 39, 40 to 59, 60 to 79, 80 to 99, and 100 to 119. Okay. Frequency is given. Okay. So that class intervals we I have taken as it is. Frequency also I am going to take as it is. 4, 14, 19, 26, 17, and 12. Okay. These two things are as it is we have taken. Now we need to find out actual class limit, true class limit, that is known as true class limit. Okay, the class limit of this is 0 to 19, but which are not continuous. When we will make it continuous, that time it will be, it is known as true class limit. Understood? So see here how to make it continuous. We know that the higher limit, lower limit of the second class or any class, and higher limit of the first class, lower of second and higher of first, any you can take, any two consecutive intervals we can choose. So I am taking here 20 minus 19. 20 minus 19. What is 20 minus 9? 1. 1 divided by 2, that is known as 1 divided by 2 is equal to 0.5. This 0.5 we need to add in the lower limit. We need to subtract from the lower limit and we need to add in the upper limit. Understood? So 0 minus 0.5. 0 minus 0.5 will be, what is going to come? 0.5. 2, 19 plus 0.5. 19 plus 0.5 will be 19.5. Okay. 20 minus 0.5. 20 minus 0.5 will be 19.5. 2, 39 plus 0.5. 39.5. Okay. So now after this what we are going to do? The same procedure. Here 40 minus 0.5, it will be 39.5. 259 plus 0.5, 59.5. 60 minus 0.5, it will come 59.5. And 79 plus 0.5 is 79.5. 80 minus 0.5, 79.5. And 99 plus 0.5 will be 99.5. 100 minus 0.5 will be 99.5. And here 119 plus 0.5 will be 119.5. Okay, now see here true class limits we got here, all the classes continuous. 19.5 upper limit, lower limit 19.5. 39.5 upper limit, lower limit of next class is 39.5. So classes are continuous. Now here we need to find out cumulative frequency by less than method. Okay, less than. Okay, so here first it is going to come as it is 4. 4 as it is going to come. Less than 39, what is going to come first? Less than 39, 14 plus 4, 18. Less than 59, 18 plus 19, 37. Okay, less than 79, less than 79 will be 37 plus 26. Okay. Sixty-three, less than 99, 63 plus 70, it will be 80. 63 plus 70, 80. 80 and less than 90, 80 plus 12, it will be 92. Understood? So it will be 4, 18, 37, 63, 80 and 90. Okay, so we got here the cumulative frequency also. Understood. Now what is required here? We need to plot the points. As we have discussed, this is the 90, upper limit that will come on the x axis. So how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 points. Okay, so upper limit is 19.5 and 4. This we need to choose because we have converted into continuous. Last time we have taken directly here because that was already continuous. So now after this 39.5 and 80. Then 39.5, 37. 79.5, 63. 99.5 and 80. And 119.5, 90. Okay, so this information, these all 6 points we need to put on the graph. Okay, so now as usual we will take here so x and y axis, vertical and horizontal axis we need to take. Okay, here see 19.5, 39.5, 59.5, understood? So difference is 20. Okay, 39.5 will be 9 and 3 minus 20, the difference is of 20. So what we can do here, suppose we will take this 0 and we need to think about this side also. Okay, so 0 minus 0.5, that will be the 0 frequency that we need to join. Okay, I will show you. So 0 minus 0.5 will be, suppose it will come here 0, then our what is going to come? 19.5, then 39.5, then 59.5, then 79.5, then 99.5, and then 119.5. Okay, then here this is 0 and this is 0.5, that is negative, minus 0.5 and 0. This point will come minus 0.5 and x coordinate, this will be 0, y coordinate will be 0 because it is on x axis. So now this is 4, 18, 37, 63, 80 and 92. Okay, so best way we can take here 10, last one is 92, 100 is enough. 10, 20, 30, then 40, then 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. Okay, so first of all, plotting point is 19.5, 4. 19.5, 4. Here 5, so this point will come here. Okay, then 39.5, 18, so 20 is here, it will come here. Okay, then 59.5, 37, 59.5 and 37, 30, it will be 35, 37. Okay, then 79.5 and 63, this is going to come 60 here, 63. Okay, then 99.5 and 80, this is here, and last one 92, 190.5 and 92 will be, 90 is here, 92 will be here. Okay, so just we need to draw with the freehand. Okay, so this is your, now see this is 0.5, understood? So 0.5 will have 0 frequency, so that we need to join here. Okay, so here our frequency curve or an ogive by less than method, we have seen both the types, when classes are continuous and when classes are discontinuous, that time how to prepare or how to draw curve, that we have seen. So today you have to solve the same examples in your notebook. Okay, thank you.